I went to Dublin to do a film which the title of which kept changing, and it finished up by being called A Likely Story. And it was a low budget film made under some kind of tax shelter arrangement. And the director was William Kronick, whom I'd not heard of before. And it was a story of a counterfeit gang, and it was partly comic and partly dramatic, and we had some lovely locations and a lovely cast, and I enjoyed doing it, but the picture never went anywhere, and it was never released. And I found out since then, I've had more experiences with other films, that these movies that are made under some kind of tax shelter arrangement, they very often don't get seen because they're made without a distribution deal. They're very often made by people who are not serious filmmakers. You know, they're setting up a picture so that they can get the tax benefits of the particular country they're working in. In this case, it was in Ireland. We were shooting in Ireland, but the money was Canadian, I think. And it's all so devious that, one doesn't want to know too much about that side of it. So it didn't get shown except within the trade, because a few months after that, I was asked to do quite a big American picture called The Wind and the Lion. And it was an MGM picture. And the producer, Herb Jaffe, had seen this little film that I'd shot in Dublin. And that's, I think, partly how I came to get the picture, that he quite liked the look of this film.